Science now shows us the best time to prune a fruit tree is summertime or wintertime, both seasons associated with pruning. Let's take a step back to really answer when is the best time. First, ask yourself, why are you pruning in the first place? We have a block that's unpruned and we have blocks that are pruned. I could tell you the big difference is unpruned is a lot less work. This orchard block is pruned. Is it pruned because it has to be? Well, if you started, I'd say, yeah, you should continue. Do you prune because you wanted to shape the tree? Probably training is a better way to shape it because the tree is young and it can be shaped. If it gets older, then yeah, it's a different story. Is it to open up the tree so that it's got better airflow, so it's got less disease? That's a good reason, and it is important. Or is it to make the tree more productive, or make bigger fruit, or nicer fruit? These are all reasons. You just gotta know, why are you pruning in the first place? Energy flow. You answered the why. Why are you pruning? Okay, now there's a big difference in the seasonal energy flow. Energy is the currency. It's what drives a tree. You see all these things? Leaves. They're all solar panels. Imagine if it's in the shade, your solar panel isn't producing much energy. The same happens for a tree. If the leaf is all day in the sun, then it's capturing energy. If it's all day in the shade, it's not capturing a lot of energy. Maybe you remember your high school photosynthesis formula that you probably learned. The currency that what is produced from photosynthesis is sugar. That sugar grows the branch, it grows the fruit, and it also grows mostly what you don't see, which is underground. It grows by putting sugar underground, building the soil and feeding the soil microorganisms. Sugar is that currency. If you're pruning in the summer, you're taking away solar panels. You're actually slowing the tree down. You're reducing its vigor a little bit. If you prune in the winter, or I say winter, it's the dormant season, the season where there is no leaves on the trees. If you prune at that time, you have to realize that the energy is not so much in the tree, it's underground. That's why in spring there is what's called a sap flow. You ever see sugar maple and maple syrup? It comes from the sap flow of the sugar or energy stored below ground, moving up the tree towards the branches, buds, and that's what pushes the leaves out in the spring. That sugary energy is what drives the system. So if you prune in the winter, like here was a pretty big cut done in the winter. Well, as that sap flow came up in the springtime, and it had a big tube, which is each branch is like a tube, that sugar and energy flowed up and said, hey, there's nothing here. Oh, that's okay. We'll just wake up a bud and grow a whole branch in the spring. Why? Because that sugary energy still had to go somewhere. So if you prune in the winter or in dormant season, you stimulate the tree to grow. It will regrow branches. It will concentrate the energy to fewer branches. And if you have fruit on those branches, well, you'll get more and bigger fruit. So keep that in mind. Summer pruning slows, winter pruning stimulates. Weather. Maybe you remember WKRP's eyewitness weather from the helicopter. Well, today is a sunny day. It's not always that. The weather does affect when you prune. Hey, summertime, it's lovely. If you get a nice day, it can be a beautiful thing to be pruning. It can be too hot. Wintertime, on the other hand, it can be quite cold, but if you're dressed, it's my favorite time to be out in the orchard because I'm tired of being inside for the winter. So wintertime pruning gets me out at a lovely time where I can enjoy sunshine and just kind of wakes up the season. The most important factor about the weather, other than how you dress, is wetness, moisture. How long before all the tree is wet? Basically, how long before it's gonna rain? If you're in a climate that it rains in winter, we get snow, but if you get rain, try to prune a few days, ideally at least 3 or 4 days before it's gonna rain. Don't prune while it's raining. That's really the worst part of it. And if it's summertime and you're pruning in the summer, there it's doubly important because all of the fungal diseases are spread during a wetness or during a rain. And if you're pruning and it's wet and you're making cuts, and now the fungal spores are moving around because you made fresh cuts. Give the tree a chance to compartmentalize the cuts that you're making. I wouldn't say heal them over, but at least block them off from possible infections. Weather, wetness, disease transmission. Whew, they go together very well. There's also the concern that, well, you know, if we prune, we should sterilize our equipment and so on. That depends. It depends on the type of organism that you're dealing with if you're pruning out disease. It depends if what time of year it is. And it, yeah, you know what? When in doubt, don't prune at that time as much as possible. You say, but I've got this disease and is it spreading? Let's take the example of fire blight. If you had fire blight, this isn't fire blight, but if you had fire blight in a tree, then you should cut off the parts that are affected. Cut them 12 to 18 inches below. And a great study from Washington State University showed they compared. If you disinfect and don't disinfect, they didn't find any difference. Well, that's because you're cutting below the diseased tissue. You're not cutting into the diseased branches. You're cutting below. You're isolating that, taking it off and removing it. So for that fire blight, if you cut according to the protocols, you don't need to disinfect. If you're in doubt, hey, disinfect from one tree to the next. But you know what? If you've got a lot of it, that takes up time. And yes, there are tools that can have a spray applied right to the blade. But you know what? Stick to the protocols, at least for that. Some diseases are bacterial, some are even virus transmitted. And if it's viruses, they're so small that you should disinfect your tools. If you're not sure, you know what I like to say, when in doubt, do it. Just dip them. It's bleach or alcohol works great to disinfect your blade or your pruners. But you know what? The best is avoid it in the first place. So prune outside of the worst periods. Don't prune in the period where you could be transmitting the disease. Make as much of your cuts in dormant season to avoid that. Why? Because when it's dormant for us in the winter, there's zero, nothing's transmitted. Everything is just parked and nothing is in a stage that it's ready to reproduce. So I like to do most of my pruning, by far 99% of it in the winter, in the dormant period, but I'm not dealing with a lot of disease. Here's a rare case. When you think about pruning, consider the size of the branches you'll be removing. I like a simple rule. If I can't cut it with my hand secateurs, I shouldn't be cutting it in the summer. Why should I cut a big branch in the summer? I leave that to dormant season. So think of it, if I'd have to force to cut it, I shouldn't be cutting it now. And that's a good rule to remember, unless you have disease like fire blight, which yes, you may be cutting a pretty big branch, but you know what? It's do or die for the tree, so yes, cut it. But the good thing about the size limitation is that these smaller branches, if I was looking, if I was looking to cut this, I could easily cut that. But you see, the size of this cut versus the size of that cut, if you think about disease organisms, they have a much better chance on a cut this big than on a cut this big. As soon as you make a cut of whatever type, you're opening up the tree to a possible infection by whatever organism it is. The bigger the surface area or the cut, the higher the chance. Doesn't mean your tree will get, but it means it's a higher chance. You really have to step back and ask, why is your tree getting infected in the first place? But it's much harder for the tree to compartmentalize a big cut than it is a small cut. So try to keep in mind and restrict your pruning cuts to hand secateur in the summer, and large cuts can be done in dormant or winter season. One of the most important factors in determining when you are pruning comes down to visibility. Look at this tree. How much of the actual structure of the tree do you see? It's summertime. I don't know, do I need to remove more branches? What is the shape of this tree? What's the branch angle? None of that information is readily available at a distance. If I get in close, I could see it, but I love to look at a tree when it's naked, look at the tree top to bottom or bottom to top, and in one glance up and down the tree, I can size up what's the situation. If there's any branches that are really not in the right angle, not the right angle of branches, maybe coming up, all that is readily visible because there's no leaves to obscure the view and the visibility is perfect. Summer pruning, I'm really limited to a small area around where I'm standing or looking. I don't know anything of what's going on at the top. And so you just get a partial picture of the whole of the tree, which is important when pruning. For commercial orchards, one of the main reasons they suggest and they practice summer pruning, well, it's kind of a response to. Trees are fertilized a lot. There is a lot of new branch growth. The branch growth that's then growing can obscure the fruit or cover the fruit, and the fruit that's in the shade don't get enough sun to color properly. So a lot of that pruning is really just to expose the fruit clusters, maintain better aeration, and in some cases even reduce the chance of getting some insects which like a dense closed canopy. But again, it's kind of an offshoot of really a lot of fertilizer. If you don't fertilize or fertilize minimally, you're going to have much less new growth. You'll probably not need to remove branches because they're not obscuring the view. So, you know what? I call that a bit of a make work project. Yes, you encourage more fruit, but then you encourage a lot more work that may be needed just to get that quality. If it's for your own use and you say, you know what, if I get some fruit that are damaged, I'm okay with that. There's lots of fruit on there. How much more do I want? Do I want every fruit perfect? Then you'll probably have to do some summer pruning. But if you're happy with maybe the color isn't all there, then yeah, it's a make work project to summer prune. One reason for summer pruning is access and ease of harvest. In the springtime, this branch, before it had any fruit on it, probably was like this. Now, it's hanging lower, and come harvest time, it will probably be down here, blocking access in our aisles. So some summer pruning can be really just to allow you to get through. And look, there's branches that we miss because we don't always think of how much that branch will change with the weight of fruit. Accessing is important. Ease of harvest relates to how easy is it to get in to harvest the tree. A lot of times it's also just placing a ladder, if you're using a ladder to harvest, do you have room to put the ladder? A lot of that ladder placement pruning should have been done in the winter, but you know what? We don't get it all right the first time. So you could do some cleanup or fixing in the summer. Yes, I had to remove this black knot. I do some summer pruning, but the majority of my pruning is done in the dormant season. Try as much as possible to prune when the tree is dormant, unless you have too much vigor. I can tell you, this block where I don't prune is a whole lot less work than pruning. If you want to find the simplest three-step technique to pruning, check out this next video.